Let's talk about the year of the monkey on the Chinese zodiac. Hello and welcome back to Jenna Gets Creative. Today I'm continuing my Lunar New Year Yin Yang Design series, and last time I did Year of the Goat, so that means this time I'm doing Year of the Monkey. I will have the playlist for this whole series linked down below if you're interested. I started early last year with Year of the Rat, and I've been doing them mostly in order, but I believe I did Tiger a spot early. The yin yang is a symbol representing the ancient Chinese philosophy of yin and yang, which are opposite forces, and the idea of keeping everything in balance. The animals of the Lunar New Year cycle in many Eastern cultures, including China, are already divvied up into yin and yang, so I thought it would be cool to make yin yang designs with these animals. Monkey is the ninth animal on the cycle, which means we have three left to go after this. Feel free to suggest new design series I can do when I finish. If you're new here, hi! My name is Jenna. I'm a freelance editor slash illustrator and book reviewer, and this is my little corner of YouTube. I upload twice a week, typically Tuesdays and Fridays, but some weeks like this one, I bump it to Wednesdays and Fridays. My content is mostly art, sometimes book talk, and I like to provide commentary and essay voiceover on art time lapses, do art supply and book reviews, do book topic tags, and collaborate with other artists. If that sounds like your kind of content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave. And to everyone watching, thank you so much for being here. If you'd like to help me appease the algorithm overlord, don't forget to hit the like button and leave a comment. For today's video, I did my planning separately in a sketchbook and transferred it to a piece of Strathmore Bristol board with a Prismacolor col-erase pencil. For my starting lines and smaller areas, I'm using a Tombow Fudenosuke pen in black, and for everything else that needs to be black, I'm using a dual-ended brush pen by Kuretake. The Year of the Monkey is my sister's year, so I'm excited to dive into the lore for monkey in the Chinese zodiac. As mentioned, the monkey is the ninth animal on the zodiac cycle, and it is yang on the yin yang. Monkey represents the seventh lunar month and the season of autumn. Lucky numbers are 1, 7, and 8, and unlucky numbers are 2, 5, and 9. Lucky colors are white, blue, and gold, and unlucky colors are black, gray, and either red or dark brown, depending on your source. Topaz is a lucky mineral for monkeys, and I can't find a lucky flower for them on any of my usual sources. Monkey is part of the first trine with rat and dragon. Rat needs dragon, dragon needs monkey, and monkey needs rat. Monkeys are therefore most compatible with dragons and rats, but also with snakes, and they're least compatible with tigers and pigs. A note on snake is that relationships between monkey and snake are either the most amazing compatible ever or an utter disaster, and there is no in between. Men born in the Year of the Monkey are responsible, enthusiastic, and have a great sense of humor. They can be stubborn and immature, but they're also very tolerant of others and want to make everyone happy. Men born in the Year of the Monkey easily look past the faults of others and are quick to forgive and forget, sometimes literally. They're opportunistic and impulsive, and because of this, they struggle to strive in a single, lifelong career. Women born in the Year of the Monkey are highly social and tend to draw people in with their warmth and beauty. They're highly competitive, full of grand ideas, and have very high standards and expectations. They are responsible and can be flexible when they choose to be, but since they're overly confident and optimistic, they tend to be easily disappointed when things don't turn out as well as expected. People born in the Year of the Monkey like to try everything and aren't satisfied with the status quo. This means they're most suited to challenging, high-risk careers and jobs that present a fresh set of problems every single day. They make great athletes, stockbrokers, editors, and lawyers. Freelance work also works well for monkeys, as they can take many short-term projects instead of signing on for years of the same work. In the Chinese system, we all actually have four animals. Your lunar year animal is your outer animal, the traits the whole world sees. Your inner animal is who you are on the inside and represents traits you may only share with those closest to you. Your inner animal depends on your month of birth, and inner monkeys are born in August. Your true animal is the traits you grow into in adulthood, and this is determined by the day of the week on which you were born. True monkeys are born on Sunday. Your secret animal represents the traits you keep to yourself, and these are determined by your hour of birth. Secret monkeys are born between the hours of 3 and 5 in the afternoon. For the fun of it, my sister's peers who are monkey all the way through were born between 3 and 5 p.m. on any Sunday in August, which means August 2nd, 9th, 16th, 23rd, or 30th. If that's you, born in 1992, all four of your animals are monkey. My sister is utter monkey, inner rabbit, true pig or rat, and I can't remember what time of day she was born, so I'm not sure what her secret animal is. For those curious, I've shared mine before, but I'm an outer rabbit if you're going by Lunar New Year, and an outer dragon if you're going by Calendar New Year, inner tiger, true dragon, and secret goat. My daughter is outer rooster, inner dog, true horse, secret pig. What are your animals? Next in this series will be Year of the Rooster. If you're looking for more to watch, I've got some suggestions up on the left side of the screen now. Don't forget to like, comment, maybe even subscribe. And if you like living life creatively, whatever that means to you, I'd love to have you along for the ride. Bye guys!